Most people in America are looking for, how do I make a life worth living and return worth having? We do this under the principles of live and let live, that every human being in America is entitled to the treaties of America. The treaties of America involve the Declaration of Human Rights. It's something I talk about now ad nauseum sometimes because of the violations that I see every single day by other human beings take away someone's rights. A simple example, I was in the store the other day and happened to back up and actually bump into a lady who was in line. Didn't mean to do that. Turned around, apologized to her, but instead of her being allowed to respond to me in kind, which she did do, her boyfriend talked over and kept saying it was fine and have a good day and all this shit, trying to take away her rights to speak for her. He tried to speak for her, and that means he'd probably try to speak for you. That was immoral. He is not in charge of her feelings on being bumped into naturally and accidentally. In life, we have moments of time to speak the truth, and we see this all the time in companies, in retail establishments, where retail employees take away rights of other people, including the visitors or guests or the purchasers and the buyers in their store. For example, a woman will be in an aisle as an employee of the store, and I may ask a question about some product that they might have someplace that I'm not finding. And she may not exactly know the answer immediately, but some matronly woman who's a manager will come up to us and overrun that child, and literally adult child, and start talking over her and answering me. At no time did I approach that other person. And that's a violation of human rights. It's a violation of allowing someone to speak. It's allowing someone to have freedom to do their jobs. In life, we have moments of time to speak the truth about America, and America is built on civil rights. The Constitution was established so that all people were created equal and free, basically, and that's what our treaties say today. It might not have been what they said long ago, but that is what our treaties say today. We also have the Constitution's amendments, which is called the Bill of Rights, and you can go to billofrights.org to learn all about that, both for adults and for kids. But here's the reality. We all have rights. I have the right to wear my own clothing without someone taking my clothing out of my traveling gear and resizing it so it doesn't fit anymore. I have the right to have my clothing that is military in nature and not have it being ripped and torn like what these people did to my military uniform. I didn't do that. I got caught on nothing. I did nothing to rip that. But someone's been ripping my pockets and ripping the back of my clothing and doing all sorts of things to deny me the rights to honor the military and the things that I do in the community for other people, not them. In life, we have moments of time to speak about rights. People's rights is why we have the current administration. They are professing people's rights. They are addressing people's rights. They are protecting people's rights. And our current military is fighting for our rights around the world and at home. We need people who understand patriotism as it is meant to be, not as it is defined in a Merriam-Webster dictionary. Patriotism is loving our country, caring for one another, facilitating peace, and allowing everyone to have the freedom of life. The freedom of life, or the right to life, is what every American citizen has when they are born here, raised here, and bred here. It doesn't mean we don't go abroad for jobs. I've done that myself and had a marvelous time and found a marvelous wife in that way. But the reality is that in life, we have the right to choose what we do every single day. And there are monsters in America who think they have rights to call people, involve people in other people's lives, who have no rights at all to be anywhere near them in any way. The lifeblood of an American citizen is the life force that the Lord God above gave them, and openly we are still a nation, thankfully, that honors spirituality and religion. We have freedom of religion underneath the First Amendment to the U.S. Constitution, but that's sort of a lark because the whole reason we came here was to have freedom of religion.